Okay, before I even say a single word about this tutorial, anyone viewing this video has to promise me that they will not add to the cliche of slow motion being put randomly into their content. Seriously, bullet time doesn't turn crap into gold. Know where to use it and when to use it. Good? Alright, let's go. I created this test scene as a demonstration of complex animation utilizing IK Booster, but I thought it would also be a great tutorial for slowing down, speeding up, or even rearranging your animation at any point in time. To begin, you'll need a brilliantly made plugin called Stretch and Snap Keys. It's a tool I consider absolutely vital for any Lightwave animator, regardless of their style of animation, regardless of the rigs they use. You can even retime motion capture with this tool, to give you an idea of just how powerful it is. Upon installing this plugin, you'll notice the interface is blatantly simple. You select two ranges of keyframes that correspond to the old and the new. I usually leave the snap mode to round, and the target allows you to selectively apply the modification to keyframes. So if you want to apply it to all items in the scene, or just one item, or one item and its children, you can do that. This plugin will work with any rig, any object, and just about any other item that resides in 3D space. Now, if you'd like to follow along, I've provided a Lightwave scene file in the YouTube description of this video right next to the plugin download. So, we have this animation of this guy somersaulting off a platform and then running. Suppose that right after he jumps, I decide that I want to slow down the animation to show the detail of the character's movements. So I take a mental note of the beginning and end keyframes of where I would like time to slow down. So frame 61 to about frame 72. I hit stretch and snap keys and enter those numbers into the first two fields. For the purposes of modifying the length of time in any animation using this tool, the new low frame is pretty much always going to be the same as the old low frame. So the new high frame is all that needs to be worried about in this case. From here, it's just simple math. By doubling the keyframes in the new high frame field, my animation will play at half normal speed. I like snap mode to be set to round, and that happens to be the default, so that's good. Now, for the target, there's several different options, as I noted earlier. I like to set it to all items in most cases, so that everything in the timeline, every single object in the scene, will get the same kind of stretch treatment. Note that this affects even locked items, so if you don't want something changed, you'll need to be more specific with your commands. So, setting it to all items, press OK, and let's take a look. Freaking beautiful. Dude, now I'm gonna make my entire animation slow motion. No, don't do it. I swear I'm gonna be very angry if I start seeing these videos starting to pop up. Please don't make me regret making this video. With all that said, there is something else that I want to cover concerning this tool though, specifically its limitations and how to get around some of them. Not everything in Lightwave is found in 3D space, and those things are essentially invisible to this plugin, in addition to particles. Let me reload an unchanged file real quick just to show you this. Now, as the character runs past the Lightwave timeline, a texture-driven displacement makes the keyframes emerge. So, when we switch back to the scene where we slowed time down at some point, now the displacement is out of sync with the rest of the animation. Man, this really sucks. How do you fix this? Well, here's my solution. If you have any texture-driven displacements or anything that involves envelopes to worry about as you do your time modifications, there's a few steps that you need to take before actually using stretch and snap keys. Let's go back to the unedited scene and work with that. Start by creating a null in the scene. Don't move it or anything, just throw it in there. Next, we look at the potential problem area, the keyframes. The keyframes here are basically just a single object consisting of an array of bars. So I select this big object, press P for object properties, and go into the deform tab, and you'll notice that the displacement map is texture driven. In essence, all I did was take an image gradient and modified the X position to correspond with the animation. Let's take a closer look by opening the X-axis envelope. See this graph editor? Right-click the X channel, copy, and close that abomination of productivity. The less time we have to look at that damn screen, the better. Remember that null we made? Let's select it, open the dreaded graph editor once more, right-click and paste into the null's X channel. See what we did here? We basically made the texture-driven displacement visible to this plugin. Now we can do the time change like before, but this time we can grab the null's modified X channel and paste it back into the displacement to make it correspond with the changes of stretch snap keys. Pretty cool, eh? If you find yourself having to do these steps repeatedly, I would suggest just having the channel driven by the null so that it'll save you the trouble of having to do that every time. Keep in mind that this trick also works for endomorphs too. Okay, as far as particles are concerned, the timing issues created by using stretch snap keys in conjunction with particles is a much trickier issue, which I don't really have a convenient solution for. Theoretically, you could drive the properties of the particles with a texture, but I haven't actually tested it, so I can't really say anything more than that. As a final word, you don't have to use stretch snap keys just to slow things down. I often use it to retime my animation. If I think something looks too slow or too fast, it's blatantly simple to do that with this plugin, and that's why I like it so much. I can just keep animating and not worry about the timing and just focus on the poses and then go back with stretch snap keys and fix it all up, and it's great. Anyways, that concludes this tutorial on slow motion effects in Lightwave. Thanks for watching.